Hey, what's up, everybody? This is your boy AJ Tripp, and welcome to That's a Shoot, my weekly episodic show where I usually talk about what's going on in the world of professional wrestling. On days like this, when it's also usually on Friday, but on days like this, it's on a Saturday, and it's prediction time. Yeah, predictions time. Hey, we're going to look into the predictions of Fastlane, which happens tomorrow night. And while speaking of tomorrow night, make sure you stay right after the pay-per-view and you come over here, click the notification bell so that it you can get the notification when I go live. Because that's what we're talking about, the Rapid Reaction on Fastlane 2021. So make sure you're here for that. Also, next week, two episodes of That's a Shoot. You get the normal episode, you get a special episode as I combine with my top 10 list and I redo my top 10 WrestleMania moments of all time. Last year I did the WrestleMania moments of all time and I forgot one. A big one. So I'm going to redo it, put it back in the list, and redo my whole list. So, yeah. That being said, let's go down to the predicting. So far this year, my record is 14-5. 5-2 at the Royal Rumble. 5-1 at NXT TakeOver Vengeance Day. 4-2 at the Elimination Chamber. So now here we are with Fastlane approaching WrestleMania. Can I keep it continue? Or will I fall off? Hopefully I can keep it continue. Let's go here. We'll start off with the United States Championship. Matt Riddle, or now called Riddle, versus Mustafa Ali. You would think that Mustafa Ali should get the win here. Because if they really want Retribution to be something special, they should give him the win here. However, he talks too damn much right now. He talks too damn much and it's really just incredible what's going on. So, I'm not sure what necessarily is happening. I'm not sure what is going on, but right now he's totally just off of the flame, you know, with Mustafa Ali. Matt Riddle just recently won it in United States Championship. It, you know, there should be, you know, some type of rank. I'm not saying they need. No, there need to be long wins, especially when you have two. It's kind of the same time. When you have two, mid card champions, as you do with Riddle, and as you do with, Big E. You know, one could be a long term championship, and another one could be the kind of championship that jumps around from player to player. And I think with Big E right now, I think Big E's doing some good work. I actually would keep the current title on Big E for a long time. And I would use Matt Riddle, the United States Championship, as the jump around type of thing. But I don't think he needs to beat Mustafa. I don't think he needs to lose it so quickly after winning it just slight months ago. Maybe that's something at WrestleMania that happens. So I'm going to say Matt Riddle. Next up, match made last night on SmackDown, Seth Rollins taking on Shinsuke Nakamura. Shinsuke is taking up with good friend Cesaro. And Seth Rollins is looking to make people embrace his vision. To me, I think this is a simple match. I think we're heading for Seth Rollins and Cesaro at WrestleMania. That's one of the other matches on the card. I'm not sure what Shinsuke is up to. It kind of feels bad to send Shinsuke out there just for like a little bit of a nothing match. But I think storyline rising makes sense for Shinsuke, who has been teaming with Cesaro for over a year or two. A year and a half to now stick up for somebody he respects. So, and try to get some payback for him. So, that being said, I think Seth Rollins here, like I said, he's going on to face Cesaro, so Seth Rollins gets the victory over Shinsuke. I have to be honest here, the next two are something that I don't know necessarily if it will happen or how it would happen or what if that happens. So I'm going to bunch these two in fact that same little segment here. First we have Alexa Bliss versus Randy Orton. Now I don't know if this is a match. I don't know if this is some type of in-ring segment. I don't know what this is going to be. There was a challenge made. Randy accepted it, but I don't know what it is. No, so I'm not sure. Like I said, I don't know sure if it's a match or anything like that. So, but I'm gonna have it down here, and I'm gonna make a prediction for this one and the next one. And if it doesn't turn out to be what it is, and it just goes away, my prediction goes away. I think one of the things I'm also gonna do is next year. I'm gonna add to it. I'm gonna predict. I'm gonna have a prediction of who wins the match. I think I'm also going to add on to that prediction like no contests. Like if the match doesn't, the match is thrown out. It ends in a no contest, or the match is, double count out or double DQ. I'm gonna add those to the selections. This seems like a no contest. This seems like Alexa Bliss, Randy Orton, they get in the ring, they move around, they stood for 5 or 6 minutes, and then from what Randy Orton has stated, he is going to kick her away, and so he's gonna get Alexa Bliss in the ring for the punt kick. And then, as soon as he goes, the lights will shut down. When he gets to that corner, the lights will shut down. The lights will go, and then the new fiend or whatever will pop up, and the match will just be thrown out. That's what I'm thinking is going to happen. That being said, I'm going to say that I'm going to pick Randy Orton because I'm going to have to pick somebody. Like I said, I didn't make the rules for this year to be that way, so I'm gonna have to pick a winner, and I'm picking Randy Orton. So that is that. Now with this next one, Braun Strowman versus Shane McMahon, there are rumors that this match may not even happen. It was announced on Raw, but there have been rumors that this may not happen because they may want to save this for WrestleMania. We'll wait and see. I'm going to pick, and this is another one to me that is almost as if it's a total double count out, double disqualification type of thing, no contest. The match doesn't even happen before Braun Strowman gets to the ring. Shane McMahon jumps him and then beats him up, pours green stuff over him again, and then leaves, and then they don't even have the match. So but again, I have to pick a winner. So if this match happens, I'm picking Braun Strowman. The Intercontinental Championship is on the line as Big E takes on Apollo Crews. This has gotten good. One of the better storylines in the WWE right now with Big E and Apollo Crews, with what Apollo Crews has now become, with being the Nigerian descendant of everything like that, showing steel and hitting on steel chairs and everything. This has been pretty good, I think. But again, I think this is another one where this is why a thing like Fastlane, it hurts this right now, because this should not be Big E and Apollo should be a WrestleMania, and this should be the one-on-one match. Should not be like a WrestleMania rematch. And I think that's what you're going to see, WrestleMania rematch. I think what could happen here is, Big E and Apollo, they have a big thing, and then, Apollo gets himself disqualified, puts down Big E again, and then that's how we see the match at WrestleMania be some type of special occasion match or special gimmick match. But I think overall, I think Big E is going to win somehow, whether it's by disqualification, count out, or the pinfall. Big E's going to win, and he's going to retain his Intercontinental Championship. The Women's Tag Championship is on the line. The champions, Nia Jax and Shayna Baszler, defend against Sasha Banks and Bianca Belair. I don't think they are going to do the whole champions have to face each other at WrestleMania thing. I don't think that's happening. I think what will happen here is Sasha Banks will leave Bianca Belair alone, kind of, you know, turn heel, and she'll be left to go it alone against Nia Jax and Shayna Baszler, as she kind of was last night on SmackDown. Natalya and Tamina, they came in and they did their thing, and that's allegedly that's what's going to go down at WrestleMania. WrestleMania is going to be a triple threat: Nia and Shayna, Natalya and Tamina, and it's going to be Naomi and Lana. Although they might be getting ready to replace Naomi and Lana with Dana and what's her face, Dana and Mandy Rose. So, or they're going to do something in particular for that. So, I'm not sure. So, I think this one's an easy one. I think Nia and Shayna retain and keep the Women's Tag Champions. Next, we have Drew McIntyre versus Sheamus in a no-holds-barred match. These two over recent weeks have had knockdown, drag-out matches. A couple weeks ago on Monday Night Raw, and then about 3 or 4 months ago, and then not 3 or 4 weeks ago, and then 2 weeks ago, you know. So now we're here, and there's no holds barred. Now, a lot of people are thinking that it would not make sense, right? It would not make sense for Sheamus to beat Drew McIntyre. Now that you've announced that one of the main events of WrestleMania will be Bobby Lashley versus Drew McIntyre. Yeah, that may not make sense. However, just go back to 2001, No Way Out. Austin was the winner of the Royal Rumble, but he had to finally take care of Triple H, right? He finally took care of Triple H, right, against Steve Austin, the Three Stages of Hell match in No Way Out. And Triple H won that, actually. Triple H actually won that match. Now he went on, and Triple H went on to face Undertaker at WrestleMania. Now, what they could do here is that they could have Sheamus beat Drew McIntyre, and then have Sheamus enter himself, say that I beat the so-called number one contender, where's my shot, and they can make this a triple threat match for the WWE Championship. That's very well and fine. But I don't think Drew McIntyre losing is quite an option. And in fact, I'm going to be honest with you, I'm going to pick it. I'm going to go ahead and pick the upset. I'm going to say Sheamus wins this match. I don't think Sheamus is going to jump into the title picture. If he does, great. If he doesn't, it's all right. They will find Sheamus another high-level feud for Sheamus to get into, I think. Keith Lee is coming. Might be back soon. Yeah, he was injured, and he was also because of COVID. His now fiance, me and him, had COVID. He obviously lives with her, so there was, you know, they had to quarantine together. That could be the United States title match against Matt Riddle. There's a lot of things they can do with Sheamus. Have a big high profile match at WrestleMania. So, yeah, they could even do maybe a cross promotion thing, Raw versus SmackDown against somebody. So, who knows? But I am picking Sheamus to upset Drew McIntyre and win this match. And finally, the Universal Championship, Roman Reigns against Daniel Bryan, with Edge as the special guest enforcer. But I think the thing here is it makes no difference here. Roman Reigns is going to win. If Daniel Bryan were to win, I may legitimately be shocked, and I may legitimately be mad. Maybe the first time I actually was mad, the last time I was actually mad at something for WWE, it was the Hell in a Cell 2019 match. But I was not mad at it for things that other people were mad at. I was mad at it because they made the Fiend into, Cesaro used 85 stomps to try to whatever. Anyway, so yeah, this one should be a piece of cake. Reigns should beat Daniel Bryan. I'm not sure if Edge is going to get involved anywhere or not. Edge does owe Daniel Bryan a receipt of some sort for a couple weeks ago on SmackDown when they were trying to beat up Jay and, when they made the match for last night for being the special enforcer. Daniel Bryan took a shot at Edge. So I think Edge owes Daniel Bryan a receipt. I don't know if it's coming tomorrow night. And a lot of people see this as a way of Daniel Bryan joining and becoming, the third member of that match. And I don't think that's the case either. I think both main events between Lashley and Drew McIntyre and Roman Reigns and Edge, I think are going to be one-on-one matches. I do. I really do. I think Daniel Bryan is going to head into WrestleMania. He'll find something to do. Guess what? Why would if Sheamus is if Sheamus is doing nothing and Brandon Bryan is doing nothing, then why not you do a Raw versus SmackDown thing where Sheamus can go one on one with Daniel Bryan? Daniel Bryan can talk about one of the biggest things of his career is having that 18-second match where Sheamus beat him. And he's gonna make sure so Daniel Bryan can have a rematch with Sheamus, at WrestleMania for the 18 seconds. And they can go out there and have 18 minutes and, give us, good things. I think this is Roman Reigns, and I'm interested to see how the thing with Edge at the Special Enforcer goes. All right, so to reiterate, Riddle will retain the U.S. Championship. Seth Rollins will win over Shinsuke Nakamura. In two matches that I don't know what will happen or don't know how it will happen, I've decided to pick Randy Orton and Braun Strowman in their matches against Alexa Bliss and Shane McMahon, respectively. Again, I'm not even sure if they're going to be matches, but I pick winners. Big E is going to retain the Intercontinental Championship. Nia Jax and Shayna Baszler will retain the Women's Tag Team Championship. Sheamus will upset Drew McIntyre in their no-holds-barred match. And Roman Reigns will retain the Universal Championship. Post your comments down below. Tell me what you guys think. Let me know what you guys in the comment section think of my predictions, maybe your predictions. This comment section is open for you guys. Don't forget to click that notification bell, because after WWE Fast Lane tomorrow night, I will be going live and we will be talking about what happened. I don't do it really fast, so make sure you click the notification bell to get the notification of when I go live tomorrow night. And for those of you who may be new here, usually I go live after every WWE pay-per-view. So WrestleMania, two nights, we'll be going live after both nights. So thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you like the video, share the videos, and subscribe to the channel. As always, be good to each other, y'all. Be careful out there. And I am out.